So Defiance was precluded by two games, Soul Reaver 2 and Blood Omen 2. The two games were written at the same time, but by separate writing teams, and Blood Omen 2 takes quite a few liberties with the canon of the series. For example, Vorador, whose death is a very crucial element to the original Blood Omen game, comes back to life, for no particular reason. Blood Omen 2 also went on to establish the Hilden, who are not explained in much depth in Blood Omen 2, but they're kinda like these demon guys that want to take over Nazgoth, I guess? A bit of Cobra Command flavor there, but you know. Anyway, as far as I can tell, Soul Reaver 2 tried to reconcile some of these things within its own game, maybe without realizing what Blood Omen 2 was actually doing with these characters. Consequently, Soul Reaver 2 fluffs up the Hilden into something huge and cataclysmic, whereas Blood Omen 2 just kinda lets him fall flat, and they're pretty much wiped out in that game. Kain grabs Raziel by the shoulders and says, "Raziel! The Hilden, we've fallen into their trap!" And then it turns out that the Hilden got pretty much wrapped up in a later era. No big deal. So Defiance hits the ground, and it's got a lot of plot holes to fill in. How did all these characters come back to life? How are the Hilden still relevant when they get defeated in Blood Omen 2? Bear in mind, Legacy of Kain is supposed to be serious and internally consistent, so they've got to figure out a way to put this all together. But of course, that's what we're all here to see, only with great big alterations, because that's what we're gonna do. So let's get back to our game.
Hello, my name is Taylor.
And I am Ray.
And I am Player One, Lord of Kain's every passing action. Yes.
That's Peyton, expressing her tyranny over the controller.
And we are presently navigating Kain in circles around the Sarafan Stronghold. Basically, we don't know where some keys are, so we're looking for them. It's part of your standard old video game security defense package. Very common, very popular. It used to be popular. Yes. All for the golden days when the red key matched with the red door.
There were so many top secret facilities set up like an obsessive compulsive fashion designer put the place together.
So I'm noticing the Ouroboros on the floor, and I think we might be in a small replica of that room that we stabbed Raziel in.
No, I do not think so. Yes. Because then where is the statue of Raziel?
That's in the future, remember? They have to wait until everybody who knew Raziel also dies. That way there's nobody left to protest a statue honoring Raziel.
Apparently, as far as Kain could discern, somewhere there was a giant slab in the shape of an eagle. And if Kain lugged it up here to this door and put it in this hole, it would unlock the door! Yes.
What's funny about the original scene is that Kain actually does take a moment to remark on how unusual the key is. Like, the game is just saying, okay, we are rational and internally consistent, so this key is kinda silly. Please move on.
It's a design thing. You've got to establish for the player that yes, they can go through that door when they have the proper key, and the key's not there yet.
Use your flame arrows to make a fool of Kain, will you? Away! Do not bother Kain again! Yes.
I think that at this time period, Kain might be the only vampire really just tuned for murder. Vorador doesn't have the thirst for it, but Kain just loves it.
Apparently they are not so well equipped to withstand Kain's rampage.
Yes.
Well, if you think about it, Kain is connected to the pillars, he's the balance guardian, so he's got all those magical powers, whatever they might be. And he's also a very old vampire, so they shouldn't be equipped to handle Kain. He's in a league way above anything they're expecting.
I guess they do describe themselves as inquisitors. I'm not really clear on what it is that the Sarafan do. A lot of the vampires are depicted as being very human, and not all that strong, which means they shouldn't take an army. But I guess the original vampires were actually... well, they were blue and they had wings.
Blue is the most devious of colors. Yes, and the wings are symbolic of betrayal!
Well, I guess that would explain blue jays.
What kind of birdwatcher's manual are you guys using?
The one that says bluebirds are the devil, apparently.
So what is the purpose of the sandbagmen here? Yes.
Well, looks to me like they're magical sandbagmans, meant to train you, 20 minutes into the game.
I guess better 20 minutes late than not at all. Unless it's too late and Peyton has already learned everything.
Mobius can see the future. Yes. He built this room specifically to train Kain with the sandbagmans.
Well, maybe while you're here with the sandbagmans, Mobius has taken the opportunity to move his people somewhere else. Somewhere where Kain will not be able to butcher them again.
Or even the first time, if you think about it.
Or even one time. Think of all the people not getting butchered, Peyton. You know you think this would upset me. Yes. But I am Kain. I am eternal.
If need be, I can wake Mobius's people out.
Or you could go back in time and torment civilians with a time-streaming device. The world is really Kain's oyster.
Ah, but Soul Reaver 2 established that if you mess around in time too much, you might cause a paradox. You've gotta have a stable time loop. If you don't, then history abhors you. which I think means expels you forever. They never go into this, but who knows how many Time Guardians got expelled from history, till they got Mobius, who was able to actually maintain the proper time loops.
That kind of makes for an interesting theory. You've got this universe where the only time streamers are people who are competent, because everyone else just ceases to exist, and you never hear about them.
See, I always thought the time expulsion thing was gonna be something they'd work with. I thought that was gonna be Kain's plan, like expel the Elder Squid from time, and expel Mobius from time, and expel cheese crackers from time because Kain doesn't like cheese crackers. If Kain doesn't like cheese crackers, right? Yes. There is obviously a valid reason and we should trust Kain's leadership. Yes.
The valid reason being that Kain is a vampire and doesn't eat cheese. He drinks blood.
Can you imagine how much it would suck to be a professional chef and then get turned into a vampire? Like, imagine you've got a Michelin star rating or something like that. You're really big, you're really good, and then you're a vampire. So the magical sandbagman's just burned up the tapestry. Yes. See, like we said, Mobius was just distracting you. With a combat tutorial? Yes? What is this, like the laser pointer to the cat for Kain?
At least he was nice enough to leave behind a health power-up. Look at that, what a good guy, Mobius. I don't know why everybody's so on his case.
Well, it's a story. You gotta be on somebody's case. There has to be an antagonist. We can't just be like, oh no, look at Mobius's record with the people. He's got a really good tax plan and a really high approval rating.
Now, what do you suppose that people think when they watch Kain walk into a room and he immediately blasts the wall with his telekinetic powers?
They think, Taylor, maybe they should switch the telekinetic powers button with the Feast on Wrinkles Ladies button. Yes.
Ugh, now Peyton, you probably could have just picked that log up and set it aside. Now how's anybody gonna lock down that bridge?
I don't care, yes? It is not my stronghold.
Now you would have much different feelings if that drawbridge belonged to you.
But it doesn't, so I don't care. Yes. In fact, I am proud, because Kain is all about destruction!
And once again, they lock themselves in the room with you! Run, guys! Run away! Save yourselves!
You know, I actually have this problem with a lot of games, like virtually anything licensed by Bethesda. Why does everyone stick around when they see that you are actively punching heads clean off the shoulders? But I know why they do it. It's because if everyone ran away from your character because he gained such a reputation, you wouldn't be able to have any battles at all.
Behold! Yes.
Balance emblem.
Balance emblem. Simon Templeman steals my role. Yes.
But look, I can look at things now.
I found the button. There is a great deal of useful information here, like, for example, that I have these telekinetic runes.
Cadaverous laceration.
And that is what they call that move when I do move plus action. Yes. Quick flurry of sweeping strikes.
Cadaverous laceration sounds like they're just smashing words together. Like, what would be cadaverous about a laceration?
It is Kain's attack, Ray! When you make your own attacks, you can name them as you please. Yes.
Okay, maybe it's a cadaverous laceration because the person who gets lacerated dies and therefore becomes a cadaver.
But then it's a cadaver-inducing laceration. It's not that the laceration itself is cadaverous. Crucial difference, you know? This is like, you can't just use adjectives however you feel like. Right? Yes?
Kain is the scion of balance and lord of all Nazgoth. He has powered up the Reaver. He gets to choose the name of his attacks. Yes.
Oh my goodness. So that was the mighty power of the balance emblem. It made some guys fall down.
Right. It made them lose their balance.
No, do you think that's really actually what they were going for?
It is not what they were going. What is this slander on Kain's killing prowess? Yes. Kain will have to kill at least 100 more people to live this down.
I feel like that must have been Kain's leadership method in a nutshell.
What? Disrespect my genius? I will kill everyone until there is no one left to disagree. It is what Kain is good at, yes?
There is no shame in sticking to your strengths as the leader.
Peyton. Peyton, use the sword on those barriers.
No. Yes.
What? Why? You hold your hand out and shuffle sideways past the doors and no, I'm not gonna access those?
It is too convenient. Clearly a trap by Mobius. Kain will not be fooled again. Yes.
God damn it. It is driving me crazy to watch Peyton play this. She can't control Kain, she runs past secret stuff. When do we play as Mobius?
Although that would be really awesome, there's no point when you play as Mobius.
Okay, fine. When do we play as a third character that I can take over? Like, maybe I can do a fake voice for them.
Well, in this game, you just play as Kain and Raziel. And about fake voices, I don't know, Taylor. None of us really have experience with, like, voice acting.
Well, we could try. I don't know. Maybe we can voice modulate one of our voices.
I don't know about that. It'd be really silly. It would just sound like you, but on helium.
At last, Kain has penetrated deep into Mobius's symbol. Yes.
I see you went back for a running start on that kick.
Well, of course. Yes. Kain enters the room with style.
Oh, I guess there's an archer down here with the special key code to get in. And now he is slapped by the Reaver.
This fool is small time to Kain. Yes. Kain has much bigger Mobiuses to fry.
Mobius thinks he has escaped Kain, but Kain is too swift. That little diversion with the training hall aside, if only the camera would point in the direction you need to go.
Clearly the camera is in league with Mobius. Yes.
It really gets me thinking. Does it take more time to set up cameras like this, or would it be faster to just have a camera that follows behind Kain's head? The latter is more efficient, but this is more cinematic sometimes.
Maybe it takes more time to set up the cameras, but it makes it faster setting up the rooms. I mean, think about it. If that camera had been behind your head walking into that last room with the barrels, you would have seen a solid wall. But as it is, you looked at the set dressing.
Kind of an interesting theory, and a good idea if true. I mean, I guess looking at the walls behind us, they're not very well detailed, but the stuff in front looks really pretty.
We're talking a game company that has a reputation for being overambitious. They might have picked something up from the one or two rushed games they've had to work with in the past.
Well, as I recall, a lot of the old games were stylistically pretty too. Blood Omen, of course, was two-dimensional, but everything else has been fairly attractive. I mean, for the times and standards that they were built by, anyway.
You did mention that the environments didn't stay attractive indefinitely. Like, for example, Vorador's mansion was good, but you don't remember some of the others. Maybe they laid everything out in basics first, then went in and prettied everything up afterwards.
Speaking of pretty environments, yes, why is there a giant cavern beneath the Sarafan Stronghold?
I don't know, but you blew up a lot of the natural supports holding it up, so maybe it's not going to be down here for very long.
Wait, what is this cavern made out of? Limestone? That's common for caverns. Isn't this a really dangerous engineering hazard?
Well, yes. Granted that there is a giant hole beneath a giant structure, it's kinda dangerous.
This is the sort of thing where there's an earthquake and the entire building just collapses into the cavern.
Normally. But this is also where the Pillar Guardians live. So there's the Time Guardian who can see in the future and he knows there's not gonna be a collapse. And then there's also the Nature Guardian who can maybe detect violent earthquakes with his feet.
Okay, your will be done. No questions here. Kain, I know you're there, buddy.
Do not buddy with Kain, Mobius. Kain is not here for talking. Kain is here to hear you talking to Kain what he wants to know. Yes.
Raziel's in another time period. No, I'm not telling you when. You smell like a corpse, and your nation failed because of you, not because of outside factors.
How dare you? Kain's nation failed because Zaphon, and because the pillars are corrupt. Yes.
No, it failed because your tax code was crap, and you replaced all the people with vampire monstrosities. So saith Mobius, the Oracle. It's a shame you killed me, I was a great advisor. Also, watch out, I've got a magic vampire-killing staff. You think you're playing a game, Kain. You look at the delicate machinations of fate, and you think to yourself, how can I fix those to make them work for myself? Well, guess what? They don't fix. They work only by the delicate machinery that you do not understand. Presently, you are at my mercy, and if I followed my emotions as bluntly as you did, you wouldn't leave here today. But unlike you, I will not fail in my role as a Pillar Guardian. At some point, my death will be necessary. At some point, so is yours. Until that time, despite whatever success you think you've achieved, you're nothing more than a coward running from your inevitable fate. No more grand than anyone before you. You're defending a tainted legacy of failure with no true meaning.
Mobius was wrong. Yes. Kain had helped Kain numerous times, and one time pulled a sword from Raziel's chest. Yes.
So as with Soul Reaver 2, the writing for Mobius in that scene was very much on the side of Snidely Whiplash, which I don't really get because Mobius has a lot of legitimate grievances.
None of Mobius's grievances are legitimate. Yes. Kain is great and Mobius is dumb.
I think, like you mentioned, they're just trying to establish who the antagonist is, which is kind of challenging when you're playing as an arrogant, bloodthirsty vampire.
It seemed Kain had been outsmarted by the devious Mobius, but Kain had stabbed Mobius once before, and would surely stab Mobius again! Yes.
And now we fade to Raziel. So here looks like a good place to stop for now. Thanks for playing with us, everybody!